Let me tell you something. Wait.
We together forever. A long time. Extremely long time.
Did you know having a brain can cause brain cancer? Thank God you're safe.
Are you sick in the mind? Are you that mentally enslaved and intellectually
You need a weed!
Even, ain't you forgetting something?
What?
My $20.
Bro, I can't believe you snuck out this late. It's gonna be so fun.
Bro, it's literally 8 p.m.
Exactly.
Bro, why do you have that?
I've never been out this late. It's kind of scary. Bro, well, I'm a pay.
Duck!
Bro, who was that?
You didn't recognize him? Bro, that was mama's best friend's sister's cousin's uncle's cat's breed. Oops.
Bro, you really just ran him over?
It was just his legs. He'll be fine. Oh my God, bro. Bye, mama.
Yo, bro, you good?
Yeah. She just says hi, but I think I'm gonna go home. I have a lot of school to do.
يا صباح الفلافل والحمص والبابا غنوج. Remember me? Ramses.
Okay. Wait! Witness, motherfucker, what?
You are a kafir as well. You are a disbeliever of Allah and the Messenger and the Quran. You have no right to call yourself a Muslim. You are excommunicated from the religion of Islam. You are out. You are finished. You are done. That's all I have to say about you.
No camera, the protection.
My name is Luis.
Hello. Bitch, I just heard he got shot in his head.
Shot. Ain't no leg shots, bitch, nigga. 40 blasts, we gon' take his ass.
I never seen my husband play football.
Pause this video game.
What?
Pause it now.
What?
I need to ask you something. Is my money my money?
Okay.
And your money is my money.
No, it's my mom's money. It's my mom's money. I don't own anything.
We together forever. A long time. Extremely long time.
Wait a minute, what's this? This ain't enough. Make it enough. Damn!
Gonna lie, me too. When I went on her page and seen her pictures, I said, oh,
jump scare.
Shua, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad.
So, you claim to be God. You gave me two eyes, but you got one eye. Fix your eye.
I don't care.
Okay.
I really don't give a fuck.
Exactly.
You my thug, you my love, you my slut. Won't turn my head, they can't stab me in my back. One man, two man, three man down.
Denial is a river in Egypt.
Assalamu alaikum.
Please.
If somebody had a gun to my head and said, spell croissants, I'd be dead.
No tomatoes, no onions. Cut in half. Tell them no cheese. If you don't tell them, they're going to put cheese on the burger.
We might not be together today, but that's why I love tomorrow.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Ar-Rahmanirrahim. Maliki yawmiddin. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. Shiratal mustaqim. Shiratal ladzina an'amta 'alaihim. Ghairil maghdubi 'alaihim waladdallin. ولا الضالين
Are you gay?
No.
Yes, you are. You're eating through Ramadan.
I have exams coming up and at times I can't concentrate. Now I have to...
Shut your mouth. That's why you're finished. Look at my life, you're moving wet.
Who's moving like that? I'll make up the day.
It's because you're Shia.
I think you're funny. I think you're really funny.
What's your go-to move?
We Palestinians called the children of the stone, but I made a mistake and fell in love with a haywan.
I start my morning every day by praying Fajr. I thank God for his excellence and all the blessings that he's gave me.
Was the angles good?
Okay, so a lot of you guys have been asking, how do I balance the gym
No one's gonna know.
After that, I hit the gym and do my daily workouts every single day.
And if you don't stay disciplined, you're never gonna make it to where you wanna be.
I was talking with the moon last night. The moon told me something about the sun, and I told something about you.
So you're telling me 1 week of every month, or actually 2 weeks, because you feel like this is before your period. So for 2 weeks, for half the month, half my life, I'm just sad and crying and moody and easily getting triggered at people. And then if you say, oh, I'm on my period, that sounds like a bullshit excuse, but it's not, because I know myself. And I feel a difference between this time of the month, you know? I don't want this. Man, it sucks. Guys should be so thankful.
Top 10 most unwholesome moments, coming in at number 1, when you code switch and people understand the code that you switch to. Other day I'm at the mosque doing what mosque-y people do, trying to get God to rate them. So before entering the mosque, I'm talking to my friend and I'm telling him something in Arabic. Now, planted next to my friend is an individual that I've never encountered before, but just by using my racism detector test, I could tell that he was full biryani. Now, as someone who's half biryani, half hummus, I mean no harm. So I'm violating my friend because that's what friends do. And the dude is so close to my friend that if he could understand what I was saying in Arabic, he could possibly interpret that I was trying to violate him. But this wasn't a double violation. I was just single violating. After a couple of time decibels of me violating my friend, I get bored. And I realize that the guy planted next to my friend hasn't unplanted himself. I look at my guy's face. He's not doing no side eye, no cross eye. He's doing evil eye. Now, after he was done third wheeling without consent, he decided to do a nationality pack opening and revealed that he was actually full hummus. And then I realized that I think he thought that I was talking about him. And look, I wanted to explain to him that I wasn't talking about him, but he was just giving me a look like he was about to spend the Laylatul Qadr dua on my oxygen supply.
You said, was it Palestine?
Palestinian.
Okay, that's what, all right, don't yell. Aggressive as What's your name, Palestine?
Jabril.
Okay, that's what's up. I never met a Jabril, but this is nice. We're gonna learn about you. Are you here by yourself or are you here with a girl? Okay, why was the hesitation? Hit loading button on that joint. He's like, where's this gonna go? Ah, Jabril, nice to meet you. Is she from Palestine too?
No, she's Mexican.
Okay. Damn, respect, girl. Is that why you're here? Because she saw my videos and like, listen. We have to go see Martin. Whose idea was it come to, be honest, Jabril. Don't lie. It was her idea.
Yeah.
Have you seen my videos before? From her? Why you say it like that? Like you ain't have no choice. Are my videos like torture to watch? Hey man, answer this right, because I'm gonna torture you. You might be sitting in the back, but you know, my roasts, they affect everybody.
Is tonight Laylatul Qadr? There's a strong view amongst the scholars that tonight might be Laylatul Qadr. According to this hadith, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said that Laylatul Qadr is on the 27th night. If you need some last-minute motivation to get you through the last days in Ramadan, feel free to check out this live today at 5:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, which is 10:30 p.m. UK time. We're going to talk about some of the most powerful ways to maximize your rewards. See you there.
It's 2 a.m. in the morning, and I want to have a discussion. I don't know why I'm whispering. Basically, this discussion is zina, okay? Zina is not only sex before marriage, but it's a lot more than that. But in this case, we're going to talk about before marriage. Hear me out. I was scrolling through TikTok, right? And I came across this video where this girl asked a question, and she was saying, like, she was asking people, would you get with someone who is committed to them when you haven't, if you're a virgin? And this is just my take on this, guys, because I have witnessed things, I have seen things, I've experienced and heard things with my own eyes and ears with people around me. And this is the conclusion I have come to. Feel free to say your opinions, but this is just mine. This might have to be in two parts, because 10-minute thing is gone and I'm talking too much. Let's get into it. Okay, my take is, a lot of people were in the comments talking about, if Allah has all forgiven, has forgiven them, then I should forgive them. If they've repented too, please understand your forgiveness and Allah's forgiveness is two different forgiveness. Allah does not contain jealousy within him. He is all forgiven, he's all loving. You are not all loving or all forgiven, and you have jealousy because you're a human being. It is very normal. As Muslims, I believe we have I might be wrong, but we have more jealousy than non-Muslims because of our boundaries in our beliefs. Okay, we have very high set boundaries. Regardless if you commit sin, you have you're morally just up there, okay, when it comes to boundaries. Now listen, if you are a non-virgin and you have married if you are a virgin and you have married a non-virgin, even though you've accepted them and probably took in the fact that they've repented and Allah has forgiven them, that jealousy in you will never accept the fact that they are not. Even though you've accepted the fact they have repented, you will never sit and be happy with the fact that they are non-virgins and you're a virgin. And I'm not speaking for all people, but there's a handful of people that I'm speaking to. No, please, just taking the fact that I'm not speaking for everyone. I'm speaking for a lot of people. Okay, with the remember, we are jealous people. We are humans. It's normal to have jealousy. When you are doing what you're doing with your husband or your spouse or your wife or whatever you want to call it, you are sharing a very intimate moment, a very special moment, okay? What you're doing is very special to you because you are a virgin. This moment might be something that you're going to cherish. The first time, you're going to cherish it, okay? Whereas that person's already done it. So to you, you're going to start thinking, okay, it's special to me, but is it special to them? You're going to start deep in life. You might not feel special because you might feel, oh, it's the first time for me, yes, but how many times has this person done it? At the back of your mind, you're always going to think about what they feel. Guys, there's always going to be insecurities as well. And I'm not speaking for all, like I said. Remember, I'm not speaking for all. But some people, they turn into hypocrites. A lot of people are going to think they're better than other people and they're going to hold it against them just because they're virgins and that person isn't. Guys, I'm going to have to do a part two because I have so much to say. Okay, part two about the zina topic. Okay, so part two of what I have, how I think. Guys, and please, this is a very open conversation. If you guys want to comment what you think, that's perfectly fine. This is not a right or wrong topic. This is how I see things. Feel free to state your opinion, 100%. This is not a right or wrong subject. This is just how we see things. Back to how we were saying about jealousy, okay? Us humans contain jealousy, especially Muslims, when it comes to morals and their beliefs. I believe that Muslims have a lot of jealousy within them. So when you are sharing an intimate moment with someone, even though you've accepted them and you've accepted the fact that they have repented and Allah has forgiven them, Allahu A'lam, it's still gonna upset you deeply inside. Now, it's not all, like I said, for a lot. It's gonna hurt you sometimes because you're gonna think, okay, this moment might be special to me because I'm a virgin. And you need to understand, you have held on to something for so long. You have probably fought so many urges to not commit zina whereas that person has probably done it. Now, it doesn't make you better than them, but a lot of humans, it is human nature to think that you are better than someone because you have done something that they haven't done, or they have done something that you haven't. Do you understand? And it might become very, you might sense yourself becoming a hypocrite in certain situations when it comes to that person, because you haven't done something that they've done. Now, guys, if us women, you might agree, you might disagree, but this is the truth, okay? This is not a right or wrong, what I'm about to say. Women are very sensitive human beings. Allah created us to be very sensitive. That's why women do certain things that men don't do, and men do things that certain women cannot do. Men are emotionally stronger than women, okay? So us women have, believe it or not, a lot of women have more jealousy than men, okay? It's normal. Us women are psycho. So I'm talking for virgin women now. I don't know about virgin men. Virgin men can speak for themselves, but I'm speaking for virgin women. When you marry someone who's not a virgin, there's going to be that jealousy inside you, babe. There's always going to be, at the back of your head, it's going to be, ooh, there was other women before. If you are that type of woman, Habiba, I really suggest that you stick to someone who's a virgin. Because when you are a virgin and you're sharing that intimate moment to someone who's also a virgin, you don't have to worry about what they did in the past, because you know it's special for them and it's special for you, it's special for the both of you. You are sharing that special moment between you two. Whereas when you're doing it with someone who's not a virgin, regardless if they repented, mashallah alayhum, may Allah forgive them for all their sins, but it's not going to feel as special. Do you understand where I'm coming from? Guys, please feel free to state your opinions on this. This is just how I see things and how I think. It might not be the right thing, but there's no right or wrong in how you see things in life. So if you're that jealous person, I just believe, if Allah has forgiven them, Allah has forgiven them, mashallah alayhum. But virgins stick to virgins, and non-virgins stick to non-virgins.
Okay.
Nothing but Allah, but it's the beginning of Bismillah. Taste for taqwa, be wearing of Allah, and thirst for thawab, a reward. Jais for Jannah, the garden of paradise. Hais for Hajj, the blessed pilgrimage. Khais for Khatam, the seal of the prophethood given to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Days for Deen, Al-Islam, religion with Allah since time began. Days for Dhikr, remembering Allah, and rise for the month of Ramadan. Oh, Ramadan.
Cordy, that was scary.
This is my younger brother, Ahmanur Noor. Here's a close picture of him. He was murdered on the 11th February last year outside of Milton Keynes College. His murderer was sentenced a few days ago on 28th February. This man was charged with manslaughter, reduced from murder. He was given 11 years for manslaughter and 14 months for possession of a bladed article, as you can see here. I don't think I have enough time to summarise everything, but please read this. And this. And this. The man who murders him leaves the building and walks straight past, walks where he'll eventually stab Ahmanur, which is right here. At this point, he's left the area. He hasn't spoken to anybody, but he comes back down and he comes back armed. As you can see here, the news reported that he was put to the ground and left to retrieve a knife, which is false. He was not put to the ground by anyone, let alone Ahmanur. This is just a lie of his that was somehow reported. Facts of the case were neglected, but this is reported. Ahmanur did not know his murderer. He did not know the majority of the boys that were there. Some went to a secondary school, which he knew of. Some were older than him, older than myself, and I'm 3 years older than Ahmanur. Before Ahmanur is stabbed, he's pushed towards the defendant. I hate to post this, but this is Ahmanur, and this is behind him, the boy who's pushing him, which throws the rock. He throws this rock at him. He already has a knife in his hand before the rock is thrown at him, as he's tussling with this boy standing over here. So he moves from that boy as he has a knife in his hand, and he turns around to stab a kid he sees being pushed towards him. Ahmanur was more than at the back. Unreleased photo shows Ahmanur was off camera by himself until he slowly pushed towards the defendant. And he's pushed by him. This boy pushes him out of the car. He went to our secondary school. We've known him for years. Him and Ahmanur had no relationship whatsoever. He's been involved in a stabbing before, and nothing was done about that either. Him and Hanad Ishmael. And he was the one who was forcefully pushing Ahmanur towards the defendant. out of the entire group, he's the biggest out of weight and height, and he's the one who could properly push Ahmed towards the defendant. He was holding him and pushing him for a good period, using his weight as an advantage. He held him till he was stabbed. Ahmed, being pushed towards him, tried to run. Ahmed was trying to run away, but his legs couldn't handle the weight of Ayat pushing him. He had all avenues to run blocked from him. The rest of them all backed up to allow Ahmed to be pushed towards the defendant. The majority of the group knew the defendant, and none of them knew or cared about Ahmed. The only injury Ahmed had on his body was a single stab wound to his back. He had no offensive marks on his body, nor had any defensive marks, meaning he wasn't hit by anybody. He didn't hit anybody. He had no marks on his body to indicate he was in an altercation. Throughout Ahmed's entire school career, he's never had any trouble ever. It was supposed to be Ahmed's last day that day, as he was going to Umrah the following week. He was supposed to meet a friend there who left the school with him, who never showed up. Kamal Abdul, who told him we'd go to the mosque together. He knew what would happen to Ahmed and never showed up. Ahmed's death could have been prevented. His murderer should have never been released or allowed back in the school premises. Please be sure to read where I've put the link up in my bio, inshallah. I can't fit this one in 3 minutes, but essentially, Ahmed was killed by somebody who already had a murder link in January, a month before he killed him. Somebody who was on bail just 9 days before he killed Ahmed. He was just out for 9 days. And inshallah, I'll make more parts about Ahmed, about who he was, about the group that killed him, about the guy who stabbed him to death, the man. Yeah. Thank you for all of your comments and condolences.